Hello, this is Jason from inspiredrewired.com, and this video is about being kind to yourself, being kind and compassionate to yourself, even on a bad day. So in my healing process, going through chronic fatigue syndrome, which I had for 11 years, I had an absolute heap, a ton of bad days. And what I would say is, it's even more important to be kind and compassionate to yourself if you're in a bit of a dip or a crash or something like that, because you know what, you deserve to actually be good to yourself and to feel good, even if it's something just simple as changing how you're thinking about yourself or how you're speaking to yourself or things that you're doing for yourself as well. So what is something you can do to be kind to yourself right now, especially on a bad day? Can you give yourself a nice bath or a nice cool shower if it's warm, or a warm shower if it's cold? Or can you make something nice for yourself, a nice meal? Or can you ask someone to do something for you, to be kind to you? Or what are the other ways? What are some things that you can do for yourself to be kind to yourself? Because you know what? You deserve that. You deserve your own kindness, and you deserve the kindness from other people as well. And I would say that me, when I was going through chronic fatigue before I did the lighting process, it was really tough. And you know what? I needed to be gentle with myself. I needed to be kind and compassionate and just do whatever I needed to do in each moment. And sometimes that meant that I would need to say no to other people if someone was being, you know, had maybe an unreasonable demand, or if it was like a get together or something that I was expected to go to, or maybe I needed to say no in that moment. And although those times when I needed to say no, that was really tough for me to actually do that, because you know, you want to get out there, you want to do all kinds of different things. However, being kind and compassionate to yourself is something that's really, really important. And beyond that, after I did the lighting process, when my wellness was rapidly increasing very, very quickly, also I needed to be kind and compassionate to myself as well, in terms of like living in balance. So not always like, you know, conquering mountains and, you know, going for like 9-hour walks in the Algarve and doing all kinds of things like that. It's not about always like pushing forwards or always doing things that are very active or high energy or high intensity. Bringing in balance to it as well. So instead of like trying to push yourself to recovery, pushing never works whatsoever. So doing things in a balanced way. So let's say after I climbed a big beautiful mountain, then maybe the next day I just kind of chill, and maybe I'd only go for like a relaxing 30 minute or 45 minute or an hour long walk the next day. And yeah, I would just like look after myself and be kind and compassionate to myself in whatever way was most appropriate in each moment. After the lighting process, it was also very different than before. And yes, I would say that something that I would very much encourage you to look at is actually changing your thought pattern. So changing, rewriting your neurology so that you can affect positive changes in your physiology. And that's also something that's really, really being super kind to yourself, is changing your thought patterns. So and stopping all of the kind of patterns that were very depleting was a huge way for me, and a huge resource in terms of my healing overall. That's what led to me actually healing so rapidly and so quickly and robustly as well. But I kept doing it in a very kind, considerate and compassionate way as well. And that actually, ironically, that was a far faster, more rapid way to recover, by being really kind and compassionate to myself. You know, recovering in a very balanced way. So doing things that I most wanted to do in each moment, which included, you know, just chillaxing sometimes, just, you know, relaxing maybe out in nature somewhere, maybe at the beach, and just enjoying myself. Mixed in with, you know, climbing mountains, doing all kinds of activities as well. And yeah, that's how I did it. So I, you know, your compassion and your kindness is something that you want to carry with you beyond CFS as well, so that you can live with balance, and so you can decide, like I could decide right now that I wanted to climb, say, the tallest mountain in Ireland or the tallest mountain in Scotland or whatever it is that I want to do right now. I could do that because I'm living from balance as well, and because I'm kind and compassionate to myself. So work on this, really encourage you to actually be kind to yourself, do things that is good for you, that you know is good for you, and keep at it, keep believing that you can get there, that you can actually get to the result that you want. So I hope you really enjoy this video. Please like, share, and subscribe, and I'll speak to you very soon.